Alright, Shalom. I want to start off by saying all praises and honor and glory unto Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai Bahashim Rachakudash Ka Halalim La Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai Bahashim Rachakudash. Double honors unto the apostles of Great Millstone, whom I have learned this truth from, who rule well, and salutations unto Joachim and Aquathim that do take heed in sincerity and in truth. Coming back once again through the spirit and power and mercy of Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai, as this thing is nearing, we're heading into the time of Jacob's trouble. We're in the time of what? Patience and endurance, man. These two words you have been hearing, and you can add faith into that, because that's the main thing that gets you through the endurance, man. That actually helps you, because this hell that we're catching on every side is no joke, man. And it'll bring a man to his knees. And if Yahweh Shai, Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai doesn't bring you up, man, you're finished, you're through. So I'm going to get a few scriptures. This is Psalms 119 and 47. And I will delight myself in thy commandments, which I have loved. My hands also will I lift up unto thy commandments, which I have loved. And I will meditate in thy statutes. And these statutes and commandments are very great, man. They not only teach yourself, or they not only teach you, right, how to how to please Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai. They teach you how to conduct yourself as a man, how to conduct yourself as a brother, how to conduct yourself as a husband, with your children. And it says in the book of Psalms that his laws, his ways are infinite, man. His knowledge, the Lord's knowledge is infinite, right? Because whichever way you're going, man, the Lord encompasses everything. We were talking with Dakim a few nights back, or actually yesterday. These people, man, they want to become homos, and they want to, become trannies and do all this wickedness. You're just, or even the case of a lesbian relationship, or etc. You always have a dominant and a submissive, man. And that's what the husband and wife is. The wife is the submissive, the husband is the dominant. But they both need each other. And that's what you see time and time again in homosexual relationships. So you're running from the laws of the Most High. You're running. You just turn back around, really, to his laws anyway. On the left-hand side, though. You know what I'm saying? That's a hell of a thing. You cannot escape his ways, man. You can't escape. You're still doing a mirror image of his righteousness, but it's in wickedness. That's a hell of a thing, man. That's how powerful Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai is, man. I'll call Halalim La Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai for that, man. Verse 50 or verse 49. Remember the word unto thy servant upon which thou hast caused me to hope, which is my comfort in my affliction, for thy word hath quickened me, man. You read these words, you hear the apostles, man, you might be having a horrible day, and it just quickens you, it livens you up, it brings you back to life, man. It gives you that jolt of energy through the spirit of the Ruach HaKodesh, man, the Holy Spirit, right? It's beautiful, man. Barakat Yahweh, Barakat Yahweh Shai for that, right? The proud have had me greatly in derision, yet have I not declined from thy law, man. These times, man, there's times you get lost in this thing, man. When I say lost, I mean like you're observing and perceiving different things in this world, how people interact with you in your own personal life via family and friends. And you sometimes get a headache, man, a migraine, and your head is split three different ways, man. But you cannot decline from his laws, man. You must meditate upon his statutes. Say, yo, this is the right way to do it. Sometimes you want to get carnal. These people test you and you say, yo, you know what I mean? Like, you guys really want me to do something? And you get that carnal demon on you, but then you must come back to the precepts of Yahweh Bahashim Yahweh Shai. You must come back to his laws, statutes, and commandments, man. That is the way that will keep you in tranquility to a certain degree in this place. To comfort thee. That's the point of this lesson, the comforter. Who is the comforter? Yahweh Shai. He came in the volume of the book. These scriptures are the comforter, aka Yahweh Shai, because he came in the volume of the book. It is written of me, thus saith in the book of Psalms. Not comforter, but volume, right? Psalms 40, verse 7. Then said I, lo, I come. In the volume of the book, it is written of me. See? Who is it written of? Yahusha. He's in the Old Testament. He's in the New Testament. He's everywhere, man. He's the chief cornerstone. Do you know what a cornerstone is in masonry? It is the foundation. You go to any large building and they will have a plaque usually with the cornerstone saying, here's the cornerstone. This is the foundation. Well, guess what? Yahusha is that cornerstone that we must lean upon in our tribulation, man. Verse 8, I delight to do thy will, O my power, yea, thy law is within my heart. See, I'm going to bring out something else in the book of Ecclesiastes, because we got this, man. We got the comforter, man. So whatever hell you're going through, man, you just remember, man, Yahusha is that chief cornerstone who is the comforter, right? This is Ecclesiastes 4:1. So I returned and considered all the oppressions that are done under the sun, and behold, the tears of such as were oppressed, and they had no comforter. And on the side of their oppressors there was power, but they had no comforter. You see? And let's look up that word comforter in the Hebrew, just to get a little perspective. The word is nacham. Nacham, which means to be sorry, console oneself, repent, regret, comfort, be comforted. And who do we repent to? We really repent to Yahusha, who he talks to Yahweh for us. We don't talk. We may say right now in this present case, so you brothers understand, Yahweh Bahashem Yahusha, which is the Most High in the name Ba in Ha the Sham name Yahusha. But we are really speaking to Yahusha right now. He is the one hearing our prayers. He is our lawyer and our mediator that is our witness before Yahweh. And he says, yo, this man is so-and-so. This man is praying to you. You know what I mean? And et cetera, et cetera, man. You know what I mean? To comfort oneself. To be sorry, rue, suffer grief, repent. See? Did not Yahusha say when his men are sealed and they get delivered, he will wipe away all tears, man? Because we're going to go through traumatization, man. We're going to go through heavy-ass times. We're heading in right now. It's no joke. Verse 2, wherefore I praise the dead which are already dead more than the living which are yet alive. Yea, better is he than both they which have not yet been, who had not seen the evil work that is done under the sun, man. It's better that you weren't here, man, because this place is hell. You have a child in this place, you're looking at him, you know, you're happy and whatever, man, you're praising the Lord, but you're looking at him like, God damn, bro, you know what I mean? You gotta go through shit in this place from when you're born, breathing in the fucking chemtrails and drinking your goddamn formula and all this madness, man, you know what I mean? All right, and we're gonna get that scripture in the book of John as well. But the comforter, but there's also one more bad scripture, man, in the book of Lamentation. All right, Lamentation 1:16. It says, for these things I weep, mine eye runneth down with water, because the comforter that should relieve my soul is far from me. And this was Lamentations during the time of Jeremiah. Lamentations means what? Crying, man. Sorrowful, sorrowness, bitterness. Those are synonyms, right? So Yahusha, you know, the comforter, we had no comforter, man. Even though he was in the volume of the book, we actually had no understanding of the prophecies. We had no understanding of certain things in the scriptures. So that comforter was not given to us. But going into, so let's finish that. Because the comforter that should relieve my soul is far from me. My children are desolate because the enemy prevailed. Right? Now let's go to the book of John. I believe, what is that, 14? John 14:16. And I will pray the Father, and he shall give you another comforter, that he may abide with you forever, even the Spirit of truth, whom the world cannot receive. The world can't get this, bro. They can hear us, they can scoff at us, they can kind of get tidbits here and there, but they cannot get this thing, man. This is for the elect. You brothers going through hell, understand this is the fiery trial of the righteous, man, that mortifies your members, man. This carnal, these carnal, wicked fucking bodies, man. Right? Because it seeth him not, neither knoweth him, but ye know him, for he dwelleth with you and shall be in you. I will not leave you comfortless. I will come to you. This is the Lord. Yahusha speaking, man. When two, hey, it says in the book of Matthew, when two or three are gathered in my name, there am I in the midst of them, man. You see? So see how beautiful this thing is, man? It's all spiritual, man. This is not a carnal thing. Verse 19, yet a little while and the world seeth me no more, but ye see me, because I live, ye shall live also. And right now we're dead, man. We're dead to the world. We're dead in our bodies, man. We're getting ready to drop dead. At least it feels like it, right? But we're dead to this world. And Yahweh Shai is dead, but he's going to be risen up real soon. He's coming back in grand style, baby. Okay, in flash, man. In pizzazz. In power. Ultimate power, man. Omnipowerful. Omnipotent. And guess what? His men will be raised up in omnipotency as well. In great power, man. At that day shall ye know that I am in my Father, and ye in me, and I in you. He that hath my commandments and keepeth them, he it is that loveth me. And he that loveth me shall be loved of my Father, and I will love him and will manifest myself to him. You can't get no better than that, man. How should I manifest himself to you? What a humble man, bro. Barakata Yahawashai, man. Tawada. For coming back and doing this bid and bringing us back to the Father, man. Tawada. What a humble man, bro. You know what I mean? These things you gotta meditate upon, because these are great things, man. So with that was really it. I want to say all praises and honor and glory unto Yahweh Bahashem Yahawashai, Bahashem Rakakodash. Double honors unto the apostles of GMS, whom I learned is true from, who rule well. And salutations unto you brothers and your sisters that take heed. I pray Yahweh Bahashem Yahawashai, Bahashem Rakakodash comforts you and increases your faith, and you endure and be patient until the end, man. Because at the end of the day, this is what the Lord said, man. This is one of my favorite scriptures. Matthew 28, verse 20. I'll start at 19. Go ye therefore and teach all nations, baptizing them in the name of the Father and of the Son and of the Holy Spirit. Which, that's not a trinity. They're not one. Okay, because the Lord, Yahweh Shai, he was created. He wasn't there. Yahweh was the first, and he created wisdom. It tells you that in the book of Wisdom of Solomon. Right? It was always there. So, verse 20. Teaching them to observe all things whatsoever I've commanded you, and lo, I am with you always, even unto the end of the world. Amen. Aman. Okay? Meditate upon that, man. In the darkest corner, man, of your fears, when that time comes, man. I'm talking about when the power is off, man. We don't got these fucking phones. You're out there, man. You're hearing people getting killed, tanks rolling through, helicopter. Listen, bro, Yahweh Shai is with you till the end of the world, man. You got to meditate upon these words, man. Hey, he that had ears, let him hear. All right? Kahalalim la Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rakakodash, Shalawam,